Heartburn is a common symptom. And the greatest concern that we as physicians have, not just gastroenterologists, any physician who deals with a patient who complains of heartburn, is this symptom an indication of reflux disease, what we call gastroesophageal reflux, GERD, G-E-R-D, or could it be something else? Could it be heart pain that the patient presents to the physician as, I think I have heartburn reflux, but yet the patient's not sure, and obviously it is the role of the physician to attempt to define this, investigate it further. For the most part, heartburn is a burning sensation. Some people call it a bitter sensation in the chest that could go all the way up to your throat. It can occur lying down, after eating a large meal, after eating something delicious, rich, such as a fatty meal, a delicious pastry with a lot of goodies built into it, eating spicy food, garlic, drinking a lot of liquor, two pieces of chocolate. So there are different food products or daily things that we do in society to enjoy ourselves that can trigger heartburn. Now, heartburn is not usually triggered by exercise. It can, sometimes if you bend forward, if you're doing push-ups, but if you're walking on a treadmill or going up a flight of stairs, you shouldn't have heartburn. So therefore, that's what a cardiologist or a physician would call it, a red flag. Be careful about that symptom. It may not be something as simple as gastroesophageal reflux, but indicative of something more serious that can be originating not in the esophagus, but rather in the heart. To evaluate the symptom further, one has to ask the patient about other symptoms. When does it occur? What did they do when this happened? Were they on any types of drugs that sometimes can also trigger heartburn or uncover something that is associated with heartburn, such as increased acid production? Was it related to exertion? Was it associated with some nausea or difficulty swallowing? Did it happen after meals? If it's associated with a meal or has some nausea, then more likely than not, one is dealing with a condition that originates in the stomach and esophagus where acid is regurgitating, refluxing into the esophagus. So, depending on the age of the patient, there are ways to approach this, dietary changes. If someone is young, there's no exercise component to it, and it goes away quickly, you can treat it with antacids, over-the-counter agents, such as H2 blockers. There are also something called PPIs, which you could buy over-the-counter. And I could list the names, but I am not a proponent of any commercial names. But just for example, Zantac, Prilosec, Pepcid, and so on. There's so many out there over the counter. If the symptoms don't improve or they're persistent and they go more than a few weeks or associated with these red flags, as I said before, such as difficulty swallowing, persistent vomiting, severe chest pain, that physician must evaluate the patient further. Or if the patient doesn't have a physician, he or she must see their doctor. Now, how do you evaluate heartburn? You do your history in some areas or centers or doctor's offices. You can do an x-ray to see if there's evidence of reflux, of barium back into the esophagus. If someone is over 50, that's a warning sign, because as we get older, and if we have had some so-called subclinical reflux for a while, there are conditions that could be premalignant that should be evaluated. Something called Barrett's, which is a tissue in the lining of esophagus that can be premalignant. So that patient needs to be evaluated further with an endoscopy. That means a camera to look at the lining of esophagus, take samples, and see if there's anything else other than just some mild acid going back into the esophagus or mouth. Now, to be definitive, one has to measure acid production. That means how much acid is going back into the esophagus reflux. And there are tests that accomplish that, something called a capsule Bravo technique, which you can place a little capsule in the esophagus, send the patient home with a recorder for 2 days or so, and determine how much acid goes back into the esophagus. There are other ways to do it with something called impedance, which is it's somewhat invasive as a capsule is, but these are more definitive testing whereby the physician can quantify how much acid, how many hours a day, what else occurs at that time, and therefore give the physician a more specific evaluation. When an endoscopy is done, samples are taken to look at the tissue under the microscope. If the tissue has been injured by reflux, there will be changes there to support that. Now, it's important, therefore, to differentiate heartburn due to reflux and heartburn associated with chest pain of cardiac origin. So it's non-GI chest pain. The cardiologists usually like to say non-cardiac chest pain. But in someone who's in their 50s or so with risk factors, overweight, high cholesterol, family history, heart disease, one should not just say, this is reflux, don't worry about it, take this, go home, and I'll see you in a few months. So if there is the lack of true confirmation of reflux, a cardiac evaluation must be done as well. So one physician needs to work closely with another, either general physicians, gastroenterologists, or cardiologists as well.